Good evening, and it's great to start another week with all of you at home. And tonight, as the nation mourns the death of Supreme Court Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg, there is already a titanic battle to replace her. The president says he will nominate a woman by week's end and that he wants a vote in the Senate before Election Day. The outcome of this fight could influence the high court for a generation to come. Justice Ginsburg passing away Friday after more than 27 years on the high court and a career as a trailblazer for the rights of women and gender equality. Her seat on the bench now draped in black. And we learned today Justice Ginsburg will lie in repose at the Supreme Court on Wednesday and Thursday. Then she will lie in state at the U.S. Capitol on Friday, the first woman ever to receive that honor, before a private burial at Arlington National Cemetery next week. President Trump saying he will probably announce his nominee this week, and we learned just before we came on the air tonight, the president met with one of his top contenders, Federal Judge Amy Coney Barrett from Indiana. Federal Judge Barbara Lagoa from Florida, the daughter of Cuban immigrants, also believed to be atop the list. Justice Ginsburg's granddaughter said in her final days, her grandmother said it was her most fervent dying wish that her seat not be filled until there is a new president. President Trump responding to that statement tonight. And so we begin here with our chief White House correspondent, Jonathan Carl.
On the steps of the Supreme Court, the tributes are coming in. Inside, Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg's seat is draped in black. Outside, the political battle to replace her is already well underway. About 24 hours after her death, President Trump appeared before supporters who were chanting, "Fill that seat." He promised he would, and that his nominee will be a woman.
It will be a woman, a very talented, very brilliant woman.
NPR reported that Justice Ginsburg dictated a final statement to her granddaughter. One sentence long, it read, "My most fervent wish is that I will not be replaced until a new president is installed." Today, President Trump implied the statement was a fake, crafted by Democrats.
So that came out of the wind. Let's see. I mean, maybe she did and maybe she didn't.
He said he's going to announce a nominee by the end of the week.
Well, I'd much rather have a vote before the election, because there's a lot of work to be done.
The president says he is considering five candidates. Sources involved in the process tell ABC News there are two at the top of the list, both now federal judges, Amy Coney Barrett and Barbara Lagoa. He met with Coney Barrett today at the White House. She is from Indiana and a former law clerk for Justice Antonin Scalia. She is a devout Catholic with seven kids and is strongly supported by anti-abortion activists. Her faith came up at her confirmation hearing for her current post.
The dogma lives loudly within you. And that's of concern when you come to big issues.
Coney Barrett insisted she wouldn't let her personal views affect how she interprets the law.
It's never appropriate for a judge to impose that judge's personal convictions, whether they derive from faith or anywhere else, on the law.
Barbara Lagoa is a former Chief Justice of the Florida Supreme Court. She was born in Miami. Her parents fled Castro's Cuba. The president seems to think picking her could be a popular move in a state he must win.
She's excellent. She's Hispanic. She's a terrific woman from everything I know. I don't know her. Florida. We love Florida. So she's got a lot of things, very smart.
Joe Biden is urging Republicans to hold off on replacing Justice Ginsburg until after the election. Among the things he says are in the balance, Obamacare, with its protections for people with pre-existing conditions. The Supreme Court will hear a challenge to the law just 1 week after the election.
And the people of this nation are choosing their future right now as they vote. To jam this nomination through the Senate is just an exercise in raw political power.
So let's get right to John Carl with us live tonight from Washington. And John, the president has said there he would like a vote in the Senate before the election. Mm-hmm. But even if it comes after, he's hoping that this battle will galvanize his base. I know that you're aware there's already evidence that from fundraising alone that this is also energizing the base for Democrats as well. It's hard to know how this will play out.
The president and his allies, David, welcome a headline that is not about coronavirus, but there is no question that this is already energizing Democrats, including many who were less than enthusiastic about Joe Biden. And overall, there is simply no doubt that this has intensified interest in a presidential race where interest is already off the charts.
No question about that. John Carl leading us off again tonight. John, thank
you. Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.